It has been 6 months now since President Yahya Jammeh began treating people with HIV/AIDS. Since then, three batches of people with HIV/AIDS, totaling 69, had joined his treatment clinic. The first group, consisting of 9 patients, joined a treatment on January 18, 2007. The second group of 23 started the treatment on 15 February 2007. And the third group of 37 patients joined the treatment program on the 17th of April 2007. President Jammeh comes from a family famous for their gift of healing.
Ndola family ala ya so re ha o ala ya so ala ya so
e nyin ye jaralo ndol fana nga tala ndol mama kono be ni ay folo folo ni ay mo bulo katita ni na ta na muta buka shabade na muta tenti na moshi tumando ba to ifango sha moy balo fango maka ngo moy adamen katita.
Jammeh himself had years back quietly cured people with ailments medically proven incurable, notably among them asthma.
That's a fact and it's a reality, because I remember in 1996, to be precise, in September, during the presidential campaign, I had asthma for almost 4 to 5 years. And then we were on tour. I remember it was very dusty because the road between when we cross Wooly, we were going to Sandu area, and Wooly West, Wooly East. So it was very dusty, and when I remember, we just sat down, and I took out a pump from my bag. That was the inhaler. So I started pumping myself. You know, I was doing like this, and I didn't realize that the president has noticed me. Then he was lieutenant, the chairman of the AFPRC. Then he called me and said, "What are you using? What is this?" I said, "I had asthma for about 4 years now." He said, "What is this?" I said, "This is a pump, which is always ordered from Bremen in Germany, and it comes every month on DHL." He said, "What?" I said, "Yeah." He said, "You had asthma?" I said, "Yes." He said to me, "When you go, don't eat anything after midnight. And then tomorrow morning when you come, you ask the orderly, I will leave something for you." And then he gave me the formula, how to do it, to put it in hot, you know, warm water in a, you know, teacup and then drink it. 3 days after we were around, coming down to Janjambure area, I realized that I've started feeling, you know, nothing. So I didn't use the pump since the third day after Base. I've never used it since the day the president saw it with me. So I went to him when we went to Mansakonko. I said to him, "I did not use this." And he smiled again. He said, "I told you, you will never use it again." So since then, to be precise, September 18, 1996, I did not have asthma and I've never used the pump.
Yaya man dama dañ mo xone dafa mëna fajj asthma mo gis ko kanila mané ko dama bëgg nga fajjal ma suma asthma mu réne ma wa bax na nako fajj kéra bu yalla défé mom mu jog di fajj asthma mu oté né dafa nekk state house ma dem bind suma tour ma dem ak suma mag bu jigen bu ñu wax ndey séka ak suma doomi mag bu ñu wax séna bu jañ biñ agé ñu dem mu jox ma garab bi ma nan ko ci taxaway la fil li wacc ci suma dina bi since that day ben xix awma ko ci suma dena bi lo xamne dama wax ne dama dem udi garab pour mën ko nan pour suma asma mëna wacca suma mag itam the same thing mom la ma wax mune mom asma bi am ben problem.
President Jammeh decided to carry this asthma treatment on a large scale over the last 5 months. Hundreds of people had come forward for the treatment, which lasts few minutes and only taken once. It entails drinking a cup of herbal mixture, except for serious cases during which he applies herbal ointment and mixture all over the patient's body. Other than that, just mere drinking a cup of his herbal mixture cures the asthma.
Yeah. La ilaha illallah. Sayyidina Muhammad. Rasulullah. Sallallahu ta'ala alayhi wa sallam. Allah akbar. Inyaku. Karake da.
Tama. Sayyidina.
Oke, Umarna. Ayo, Adi. Ajita. Ini dah hal.
Presiden Jammeh jaralo. Abiti yata ayen konta menate mo menne kamutal. Bari biray boro dinna. Ayen balo frote. Nkito ko mo menne na masasa. Sa imba tento la mbaje la jaralo nyi ala mata la nyato. Sanjina ni ni asuma benna. Nin nayem boyindi nin tate ka amino feeling kenna e pompol ye borol dinna aman fen jaram bala birin so manda nabe nyola bar birin dun ta jandoro alhamdulillah.
I've seen some very amazing cases. I have an example of the young lady that was admitted in the accident and emergency and was on IV treatment, intravenous treatment, for a whole day. In the evening, she dragged herself to the glass house for treatment. And within 15 minutes of taking the medication given him by His Excellency, she was up and running. I have seen quite a number. In fact, I know quite a lot of people in high places, ordinary citizens who used to be regular patients of the accident and emergency. And since the treatment from His Excellency, we haven't seen them again. I know quite a lot of them.
However, the announcement of curing AIDS sent waves of mixed feelings in some parts of the world. For some, this was impossible. Some got very hostile towards this discovery. For others, curing AIDS was a controversial subject matter for anyone to touch on, whilst for some others, such news brought them great hope and relief. 6 months today, this program takes a look at the health status of the patients and the ongoing HIV/AIDS treatment. We will begin by looking at the first patients to be discharged by His Excellency President Jammeh. Thirteen people got discharged, all looking good and healthy. Fatu Kao, Dado Jawo, Fatu Fadera, Usman Saul, and Adam Amane came from the first batch of patients who started the treatment on January 18th. Suleiman Sanyang, Yafai Ture, Adam Asane, Tide Jiba, and Keba Sediken are from the second batch whose treatment started on February 15, 2007. Aja Ture and Dembaba came from the third batch of patients who started the treatment on April 17, 2007. What were their status like before joining President Jammeh's treatment? How did they fare through the treatment? And what next for them? The duration it took to get each and every one of these patients to a state of undetectable virus in their blood samples varied. Dr. Tamsin Bo is head of the medical team assisting President Jammeh in his treatment clinic. I asked him how long it took each and every one from the group of the 13 men and women discharged to get to an undetectable status.
Within a period of 3 days to 10 days to 1 month, depending on the amount of their viral loads in their systems. These patients were discharged, most of them after 3 days, some of them after 10 days of treatment, when their samples were tested and were discovered to be undetectable.
And each of these patients has a unique story.
I discovered I had HIV in December 2005.
How did you get to know that you were HIV positive and suffering from AIDS?
I got sick. I thought it was malaria. So I reported to the health center, a private clinic in Cape Point that belongs to Dr. Pachanjai. Then he tested me and so it was not malaria. Then he asked me to report to RVTH the following Monday. When I reported there, he took me to IDC. There, I was tested. When I was tested, the voluntary counselors told me that I am HIV positive.
Now, you said you were sick. What was wrong with you?
I had headache, continuous headache. Then in the end, I keep on vomiting all the time. I could not eat. I could not even drink cold water. The only water I could drink is only when it is a bit hot. Then I know I am.
And what was the situation with your body, you said?
My body, well, I was weak, completely weak. I cannot do anything for myself. Even to go to the toilet, people have to take me. To wash myself, people have to help me. Anything I want to do, I was helped by people. Throughout the whole night, I had sleepless nights. They would stand or with open fans to find me up.
I would recall the time exactly in 1996. I was attending a program at the University of Leeds when I realized some, you know, bodily feverish, you know, inflammation of the lymph nodes and these sort of things, which caused me to consult the physician at the Leeds University, and he suggested that, you know, I should, you know, go for an HIV test, which I had done. It was out of that test that I came to realize that I was HIV positive.
Ngakala muta 2004. Yakala muta nyadile. Nsasa atale nun tata lufitano. Ila sasa musi sasa jisifa jumareti no. Sin sasa, nasingoleka twenkeno mbala katama. Ani ngaji mbalo kaduya vake. Ani mbuka sawarda.
Nga kalam to wato minna ko HIV ben o modi ya 2000
ya kalam to nyaadile
ay mbondile kurantale ngalla so ina tan samalbtanoto birikam hanson ke so melari woleto ina tan na yelota ya test ina rajo HIV le ben ya fonya jela fanato ya nenne na bolu nya ko leyatale ka to komanto nga foynu nenen tele balu nyaabo kolar num bakele birin kuranta ngalla nawla kono na jaralo tata moro la karolla ko su wato hakilo mantani kanko nyanta tala l'hopital le ta tanina ko ila cd4 jita bakele say nyanta arv start la ya nata na cd4 fonye ko na cd4 be tati so nyanta st arv start la fon sonta bambe ko stiya ko ya konten ko en sonta bari mbi jakalle neno arv mbole takan nenam be arv takan nenam be ko kuram fang foni arv mi nenam buka domor keno haf mburo ninga muta ninga domo ninga banno kadda woleto so manda ninga domoro fanke nen di whole day alon ko suton be domoro kala konton fon da tejetu kon kote nenam mbole nyama rek mbole nyama nen adu ARV ya tandina ko niya bula within even a month ibe fala le atamanyan distance sort la atanyan tarla minala for the rest of your life for ila dunya balu mebe he nene say na tamire bibi ARV minna birib ila balu mu mebe ya be ke ARV mingonti lungo lum fajane lung minete be fala o fon damma miro damma kon no fon par dam fala fan.
The rest too shared similar stories. The world seemed to have crumbled over them. The invitation to join the treatment has always been made public and with conditions. You have to have medical proof of being HIV positive, and two, you have to agree to be treated openly, but for some exceptional cases. With these conditions met, what next? What does the process entail?
People, they register voluntarily to come for the treatment. After the registration, we confirm their HIV status, whether it is HIV 1 or HIV 2 or the combination of the two, HIV 1 and 2. Then from there, we do what we call a general medical examination for the patients. That is the physical examination of the patients, and then laboratory investigations are conducted on their blood samples to know their LFTs, the BUE and creatinine and other investigations.
At that point, do you also take their CD4 count and viral load?
Obviously, we do take their CD4 counts and their viral loads to know actually the CD4 counts for each of the patients before the start of the treatment, and their viral loads too before the start of the treatment.
The majority of patients arrived with low CD4 counts, some of them as low as 50, and most of the patients came with medical conditions.
They come in with different complaints like headache, dizziness, general body weakness, loss of appetite, skin lesions, diarrhea, insomnia, loss of weight, many, many complaints, chest pain, cough. They come with different kinds of complaints.
Tuberculosis is common amongst people living with HIV/AIDS. Now, when some do come with tuberculosis, what happens to those patients?
When you have TB, you are referred to RVTH, where you have your TB treatment first before you join the treatment. That is if we diagnose it before the start of the treatment. But once the treatment starts and you have any condition like TB or like tumor or any other disease, we normally take care of you whilst you are also in the hospital.
After the important formalities, the treatment begins. Carried out by President Jammeh himself, the treatment involves praying over the patient, rubbing of herbal ointment and mixture all over the patient's body, and ends with the administration of herbal drink prepared by the president himself. Few days after, President Jammeh checks the response to his treatment and level of stamina.
Any pain? Go and meet it.
Any pain? No, no. Any headache?
No.
You don't feel?
Absolutely.
You know?
Huh?
Dara?
You know?
You know?
You know? You know?
You know? You know? You know? You know? You know? You know?
The result of this treatment, few days after the start, has been described by many and the patients themselves as exceedingly remarkable. Fatou Jatta is one of those patients who arrived in a terrifying state, hardly able to walk.
Bima don ñew dañ ma tié amon na metit lol sa ka suma ñetti fan bima nané garab bima commencé garab bi bem am ñetti fan bobu sonon na torop be biñ démé sa man yegatuma dara lan mo nekk di xew man dañ ma utal lal bo xamné dama faté da be biñ paré pour ma dugga ci biir ñu dimbélé ma dugga ci biir way ci diganté bima duggé ci biir tamit less than 10 minutes bima président lalé ba paré man ma jogal suma bopa waxul suma bopa dox ma melni ko xamné dal dañ la solalon bu bobu toy ñu simi lako ma dal di oyof man dipi bobu nak si la dora am jaama metit yu ma dan sonal wax dega neex yalla sonala tuñ ma legi amatut
ni mbalo bi ñame waatu la comme nga fo ñame dro ni ku rangula natanañ
kurango ni ato kurang kilingo natna ni nemboko domorke mbolo be mutala be jala be kos mini yelo nu kombo kono yenje anim tumo mina meftala present jamema ate o kilingo le munno ni nembe kurandi nembe jare sante ko enjel sai sai fambolo tala do man because am dimbati ni bi jang koma somtay mirandi wolfa be bar watu so nenje fambalo ko tonya ni akende atat ala kibrinata jara lo fana kon nene jannim be start la yinna yelo tale tuku ka confirm ko HIV le ben so inata na bulota tukun samplota ya test ya je ko tonyal HIV le am o kola ngana present jamela treatment o start nene bringa treatment o fana start alhamdulillah rabbil alamin nene kudu believe tributing 3 days ton ta fanga lon ne ko fenne botam bala mbot treatment press nyamal treatment mbaka be boro min be boro min 15 days 14 days 15 days nyaw yen blood sample ta ya sen result onata drong negative ta nene bari ñu kabo wotuma la fa sañi say na fam comme do miro ke ya say na fam mbukata practice wala do manin sa fa ñing few weeks wala kon bari ale lu ngol nda som nda nene nka bor le many kilometers ngana
no before present jamela treatment buka wokeno
ka ngkoy ko mbika ku keno nene hani nyany singol fan nimbe camera mo min city because munemo ni singola be ka jia be kam muta woleto
nda de birin kanaja ya taram be nyame be batari mbake ka tu hani ta mo mbuka keno na singol ka balanne e bukata mbukata no dula jangoto anin siso wo mbukata no dula jan nin tata doron ate mela doron ngabata bari sa ngaje nyamento na fengo men kandiminu say wo be bota say kay alhamdulillah rabbil alamin nte nyim boro ayen kenyamen say a hani mo yenje hani amanyinin karo ke ni yenje ibalon nako to nya to nya nyim boro ay doko wo ke nte la karola anin na mul menul beja
I was on this ARV drugs which also helped me a little but it has its side effects before I was given the drug the doctor told me that these drugs I am putting you on has its side effects and when I started drinking the drugs taking the drugs I know it has its side effects because anytime I took it in the morning I must have diarrhea anytime I took 6 tablets daily plus septrin and other tablets
so you were taking a lot of tablets daily
yes I took more than 12 tablets daily
Two of them were particularly in a very, very bad state. In fact, I had a lengthy discussion with Echi that these people were too ill, he should allow us to take them to the hospital. But he was very confident. And we saw the results the same day. Because the moment they were given treatment by 5 p.m., one of them was dancing away happily.
Indeed, the patients felt better and looked better soon after the start of treatment. Just as the results of the tests carried out in Dakar and Morocco proved. For the first group of patients, the first tests were carried out 5 days after the start of treatment. The results were impressive.
Before the treatment, we have patients who had a CD4 count of less than 50 and now are having an increment in their CD4 levels to about 200 to 1,334.
The second test were done 10 days after the start of treatment. Again, the results were impressive.
Let's go back to the second and third groups of patients. Could you recall how soon did they test them to consider their CD4 counts and viral loads, and what were the results like?
Oh, the results were very satisfactory. After the 10 day, I could remember samples were sent to Morocco. Where CD4 and their viral loads were tested, and we had very positive results.
Du boulet lañuy deglu reuy Cheikh Anta Diop sénégalais la carbone 14 degon nañ ci mom lu bari waye danaka africain lañ ko sétane gisat nañ fi lenen lu bess moy yaaya ñewna ñepp deug nañ ne day faj mom suppom wax nako et que firnde bobu laboratoire aussi ñom ñu ngi wax ne gis nañ ay résultats yu positif kon dama ne yaaya def na waye amna lu xewati bir afrique kon koku dañ ko wara jappalé waruñ ko sétane dafa wara jeex africain ñuy deug né africain jogna créé na wala gis na lu bax nit ñi diko tankamlu wala ñukoy sétane su démé di faj di gëstu di wër ba lu melni sida bëgg jeex yakarna afrique yëpp wara taxaw jog xamné jotna nak africain def dara kon yaay ñu koy remercier nan africain nañ jog jappalé ko gis nañ li muy def té lu bax la.
When I heard this, it was not a surprise, because as we always believe, President Jammeh really loves us, and this is a real manifestation of his love to the Gambian people. As you cannot always be saying I love you, but to put it into action, this is what he has done. He really showed us the love he has for us by caring us, preventing us from dying.
Sida bi dafa di jangoro bu nga xamne sonal na aduna bi bo batay tuba bi nga xamne ñom ñoy wote xam xam def nañu ba son batay mënuñu ut luy faj jangoro ji donc ñun buñu déggé tay ni ku melni yaaya Jammeh da koy faj dañ koy rafetlu manam dal contane nañ ci dal.
Well, we are very much happy about the discovery, and you know, with President Yahya Jammeh, we have no doubt that there is nothing that is impossible. Yeah, he's a great man.
Jot na ñun africain yeb ñu taxaw yok suñu taxaway xamne fu nit ag tay ci aduna bi ag nañ fa agon nañ fa amuñu won takute gonne ag nañ fa donc tay bu li xewé aduna sepp tele ñun africain ñu mën dañu wara wone ne fu ñepp ag wala fi ñepp agagul ñun ag nañ fa.
One outstanding aspect of President Jammeh's treatment process is a patient on antiretroviral drugs must cease using them immediately when he or she joins his treatment.
You know the way these antiretroviral drugs act, they act at different parts of the cell. And you need to continuously bombard the cells with these antiretroviral drugs to see their effects. So when you stop, they just rebound. That is why we advise our patients, once we put them on it, they stay on it for a lifetime. On the other hand, with HE's treatment, what we have seen, we've never seen before. The rapid reaction of the patients to his treatment is amazing. You need to be there, or you need to follow our results, which we have been pasting on the website, to understand what I'm saying.
I noted with interest the reporter from Sky News was quite concerned about patients stopping the antiretroviral drugs, and this was a question put to His Excellency.
One of the issues that's brought up some concern is the fact that when these patients come to you and do your treatment, that they are asked to interrupt their antiretroviral treatment. And it's well known, at least you know in the States, etc., that patients that have AIDS and that interrupt that treatment can then have quite serious effects. So that's one issue that I wanted to ask you about. You did partially address it outside, but I wondered if you could speak to it again.
What I said is very clear. You don't mix my medication with any other treatment. Now, it's up to them. Those who are on ARVs are still here. You go and ask them, they'll tell you when they were on ARVs, what they were experiencing, and when they came and started my medication. I would not mix my medicine with anybody's medicine. Because if that's a complication, they would say, it's the president said he can do this, and this is the complication that has developed. That was why, if you want to take my treatment, it's voluntary. If you want to take my treatment, you will not take ARVs.
The benefits of Jammeh's AIDS treatment, as observed by various stakeholders, have great impact on all sectors of the Gambian society.
Since the breakthrough, I would say the number of people seeking VCT has almost tripled. You will recall there was a time when NAS, that is National AIDS Secretariat, in collaboration with other stakeholders, this was during the time of the ARI, Accelerated Results Implementation, it's a World Bank project. the sole aim of which was actually to bring out people to seek voluntary counseling and testing. But since that was indeed a success, but I will tell you, President Jammeh's breakthrough is even more of a success. And as we go on, I'll tell you one of the reasons. The simple reason is before the breakthrough, we were seeing, on the average, my counselors and myself were seeing like 3 or 4 cases, purely voluntary cases for VCT. But since the breakthrough, these days we are even overworked. That was the day I was telling the CMD that we really need some more hands because of the workload. More and more people are coming out purely on voluntary basis. Purely, meaning they are the ones, nobody is pushing them, nobody is coercing them. They are coming out plainly and just telling you, I just want to know my HIV status. This is indeed a real and hard fact, Nene.
And this is very critical in the fight against the spread of HIV/AIDS.
Indeed, Nene, you see, the issue is when it comes to HIV and AIDS, the bottom line and the entry point for that matter is VCT. It's like, if I'm to talk in the layman's language, like if you have a house, the key is VCT when it comes to HIV and HIV AIDS care. The world all over, the yardstick that is used to measure success in terms of HIV care is VCT. So, you see, when you look at H's intervention and his breakthrough, that's the beauty of it.
As a sector, it's very gratifying for us to know that there is a breakthrough in the treatment of HIV and AIDS. As you know, the education sector has, I think, the largest share of the employees in the public sector. We have about 6,000 to 7,000 teachers in the system, and they are not even enough. We're trying to get more and more of them in the system. And if we don't have more and we start losing some of them due to illnesses related to HIV and AIDS or death through HIV and AIDS, it's a real cause for concern for us. So when His Excellency the President came up with this treatment, I think I was one of the happiest for the fact that I know that he will be part of the crusade to help us contain the number of teachers that we have in the system and make sure that they are healthy, they're able to deliver what they're supposed to deliver on time and meet the number of hours that we want the children to be in school.
But President Jammeh's breakthrough in the fight against this pandemic was not taken kindly in some quarters. People outside the Gambia and some international media try to discredit, or better still, dismiss his discovery.
Why do you think the declaration to cure AIDS by His Excellency President Jammeh angered some people outside the Gambia?
Thank you very much, Nene. I think the reasons are very obvious. You must recall that people have been doing research on AIDS to cure it for several years in the West without any success. The discovery of this therapy by President Jammeh and the application of this therapy in such a successful manner has incited a lot of jealousy in the international community. You must recall that the people in the West think that they have a monopoly over science, particularly medical science. For us to have made this discovery, at least discovered by President Jammeh, as an African from a little country called the Gambia, obviously will incite a lot of negative reaction from those who control the drug industry. Remember what President Jammeh said, his discovery is to assist the poor around the world. The pharmaceutical industry or the drug industry makes billions out of making drugs. In fact, it's the second largest industry next to the petrochemical industry. Consequently, for President Jammeh to come out with a cure that will be available to everybody, it's like pulling the rock underneath their feet. Consequently, it's a matter of economics. And as a result, they would like to sabotage such a discovery as much as possible. But the fact of the matter is that this discovery has been done by President Jammeh and the West is not happy about it because it means that they cannot manufacture these drugs in the future to sell it expensively all around the world. That's why President Jammeh said that this discovery is for the whole of humanity. I think another important thing is that the discovery is done from a small country, which is the smallest in the world, that no one expected to have made such an incredible discovery. But we are lucky that the discovery was made by President Jammeh, who comes from a traditional healing family.
It is a multi-million dollar industry, pharmaceutical industry, and they all have their interests at stake in this kind of activity. They have developed drugs, they have treatment for people, they have all kinds of programs developed, and there is money there. They have interest in that. However, if a cure should be found, then it means all their investments would come to nothing.
It is rather unfortunate that there are outsiders who negate the president's healing. Rather than get closer and give it a chance. But at the end of the day, who cares? Who cares what they say? As long as it works for our people, that's all that matters.
Lo aduna bi yow wax ne buñu ko fajj yalla may ko xam xamam bi ci xolam bu rafet dimbalé ko be muñ ko fajj té olof li ñoo wax ñu né wéddi gis bokku ci ndax ñi nga xamné ñom lañ ñu wonon ci télévision bi ñun ñepp ñu jakarlo ñom bi ñoo commencé fajj ñepp gis nañ leen légui biñ leen gissé ko ci gis xam nga ni ki ku fébar la ndax sa dom sa bu fa né do fa suba be ngon jot mu fanan xey fébar boko xeyé sa xal xanam bi boko gissé rek diñ ko xamé ndax nit ku febar ku nek xamna ko nit ku febar di tane itam ku nek xamna ko ku wer itam ku nek xamna ko
yalla lu ko neex may ku ko neex lu ko neex yalla mom la sopp mu may ku ku gemu dal ñu xamne se gem yalla dafa rafetul rek.
If this discovery was made by a European, I am 100% sure by now billions would have been pumped into his or her account to ensure that he further develops and strengthens the research for the benefit of mankind. But because it is African, a lot of them don't want the credit to come down to Africa. That is why you have some people speculating and criticizing. But there is no doubt that the treatment is real and it is true.
We can't say something without telling him thank you. We are proud to have president who have this courage to say, okay, you can't do this thing. Me, I myself, I can't do it. And sometimes we used to be really bad, because if an African say that I can't do this, his brothers African go to fight and against him. And nowadays I think the young people we have to support him, to tell him, okay, go ahead, we are behind and we will give you the force you need to succeed and to show them that we are the greatest.
And for the patients, this is how they feel.
Hasidi yale moti ntenga jogo hasidi yale katu bi jannimbe talab lobtan la treatment wala kumbe kurandin no birimbota wo mbe morol la karol lanu mbota morol ya wato minna ndata lobtan ngaji ko morol ka fan yala fanyira jo nga foy jang katu tole boro min dinna amang kende yandi because ARV bi ke kende yandi akila kurang tenkundi dula kilen bara be balo ko landa be do mo kanne non kende ate wot birimbot na nje natna mammi nonu wo wato lambe lo tan treatment ko wato min mammi non woto ni nato no sañi woto kende atal
ku ma chaminte mo xam la ca saf ñun ñi nga xamantene ñoko ma ca nak xam nañ lu fa saf waaw parce que ñun ño amé fièvre bi ñun la fajj ñun ño mëna wax nit ñi ndax deug la wala du deug
wor nañu ne president bi fajj nañu tay fajj nañu elek té ñeneen ñu fi nekka tamit alhamdulillah ñom fum ne ni ñepp a wër fum ne ni ñom yeb dinañ mel comme ñun niñu mel.
I often cite myself as one of the best examples of president evidence of president treatment
nde kende atal nde virin nata ji bi fom vinaje hani kakka si julo fango muta mano hani kan ku fango problème ola very saying alhamdulillah fen wo fen mo kende yari ngol sakeno inte fana sakeno.
The beauty of medicine is the restoration of the sick to health,
And once His Excellency the President has come up with medical herbs that have the potency to treat and cure AIDS, I think he should be commended. He deserves to be commended.
True medicine is all about curing the sick.
The patients who regained their health and tested undetectable joined President Jammeh's team of helpers in the treatment process daily. This unprecedented intervention in the fight against HIV/AIDS by the Gambian head of state has changed the status quo in the Gambia, not only of people living with HIV/AIDS, but also the issue of stigma and discrimination that, of course, adds to the problems of people living with AIDS.
President Jammeh's breakthrough is one of the success stories again. One of the take-home messages about it is that it has tremendously pressed down the issue of stigma. Now, you see, many people are coming to the clinic these days, talk about HIV freely, very relaxed. You can see this in them. During counseling sessions, sometimes you even wonder whether this is the average Gambian man I used to know about HIV. There were times when if you talk to people about HIV, they would rather just go and leave you alone there. Those days are gone since the breakthrough.
We live with the memory of, you know, the president, you know, whom we all see aloof, you know, high up there, coming down to the level of the common man, you know, eating, you know, shaking hands, cuddling, sharing jokes with people otherwise, you know, dejected, you know, in society, stigmatized.
13 people, men, women, and a child, had been given a clean bill of health. More than 45 patients continue the treatment, and more will come to partake of this God-given gift. Meanwhile, the remaining patients who had come with various kinds of problems continue to respond positively to Jammeh's treatment.
Thank you.
The man, who comes from a family endowed with gifts of healing, says his inspiration to fight this pandemic is purely out of his love for humanity.
The inspiration is from the religious point of view, being of service to serve humanity in the name of Allah. So the powers come from Allah, the inspiration is from the Quran that you have to be of service to humanity. You know, you cannot pay Allah with money. You cannot offend Allah directly in most cases. But you can offend Allah by offending humanity, doing wrong, evil things to human beings. You understand? So if you do good things to human beings, you are serving Allah. And that's the inspiration.
I want to pray for President Jammeh. I cannot pray for him. But all God the Almighty, who has greatness to mankind, let him go with President Jammeh, help him in all his endeavors to ensure that this treatment be a lasting thing for mankind.
We need to celebrate the resource that God has given us, because Africans usually don't value the people they have until they are gone. Today, when we talk of African history, we talk of great men that have been there before, but people never valued them until when they were gone.
I'm going to go to the hospital.